have shelter and be protected and nothing can hurt you.
Keep you safe from dangerous things like bushfires. When you cross the road, you would usually hold a grown-up's hand.
Good friends, you need to stay positive. You have to include people so you feel happy.
I need good friends, make positive choices, have a great teacher.
I think you need good people to support you, good friends, good family, and people who will just stick with you to the end.
If I want to be healthy, I should eat lots of fruit and vegetables. I should be active and exercise.
Maybe read a book about it, or maybe even search the internet for safe sites, because some sites are unsafe and they should not be seeing that, otherwise they might get hurt.
Being open and involved with what you do, making sure that you enjoy what you do, whether it's at school or outside of school, and to always try and put all of your effort in it.
Well, I think obviously there's the given of food, water, a place to sleep, because you think you can't survive without those. But I think it's less about surviving, more about thriving.
To be proud of who you are and show others that you can be who you want to be.
A roof, a bed to sleep on, food and water to drink, and the books and the TV and all that stuff.
Awesome friends.
Be an active bystander, reach out to them and help them when they need it.
Listening, helping, they can be brave to help others.
Probably you can ask them, how's your day, or you can give them a present.
Instead of banning the internet, we could do certain sites that you could go on and maybe have some suggestions you might like, but only if they're appropriate, not inappropriate, otherwise that would be bad. Sometimes our parents can help us because we can't do everything. They can. They can do more things than us.
Essentially, treat others as you want to be treated.
How you say things and how things come across can really affect people. And so I think it's about fostering an environment that's supportive and showing support through action and words. And
it's 30 years since Australia ratified the United Nations Human Rights Treaty on the Rights of the Child. It identified the particular rights that apply to children, rights that international governments commit to upholding and protecting. These include the right to be educated, to grow in a healthy environment, to have a safe and loving home, to be clothed and fed, to be listened to, and to be treated fairly. In the community of the Church, these human rights of the child are grounded in the truth that each child is made in the image and likeness of God, with unique beauty and dignity. Each child is known and loved by God. As members of God's family, children also have spiritual rights that need to be identified and nurtured. The right to know their identity as children of God, to grow in knowledge of faith, to exercise the spiritual gifts of understanding, joy, courage, wisdom, discernment, and other gifts given by the Holy Spirit. In our Diocese of Broken Bay, during the safeguarding month of September, we are launching a framework for the rights of the child. It outlines our commitment to the child's human and spiritual rights and aims to empower our leadership and culture to understand and practice these rights. The framework provides a platform for developing a community that upholds the best interest of the child and integrates this approach into our relationships, programs, structures, and ministry. So who will use it? The framework can assist all members of our community, parishes, schools, Catholic care, and chancery, as a guide in the development of policies, programs, and practice. Those who work, teach, volunteer and serve across the many ministries in our diocese can make use of the framework to raise the profile of the rights of the child in every context. The framework is one of the many ways in which we are living out our commitment to forming communities of safety and care, especially for our children. I commend this document to you for your contemplation, prayer and use as we work together to build the community of the Church in Broken Bay. I'll leave the last words to our children.
Everyone, like your friends, your parents can help you find a good school, your teachers, the staff, the vice principal, the principals.
I think it's everybody.
My parents, adults and teachers, priests and bishops. Bishop Anthony.
Your family can help you, but also the government and like politicians can probably help you.
It's our job, but sometimes we, like I said, we can't handle everything, so sometimes we need a bit of help.
At the top of it all, the parents probably provide the most lessons towards the kids, so I think they're quite responsible for how children in general treat other children, how they support each other or how they are with each other.
It is so important to have people who you know and love and trust, because when you have someone you trust, no matter what's going on, you have someone that you can go to that you feel is there to help you.
First of all, you yourself, make sure you make the right choices and like follow the right guide of our teachers and parents.
What makes me happiest is being with my friends and being with family and being able to go on Skype with my cousins because they live in different countries.
Or when people include me into their games, when I get something right in like a test.
Probably my sister.
My family and my friends.
Spending time with my cousins or any part of my extended family.
I really like being with the people I enjoy being with.
Support from friends and family. I think that makes me the most happy in the entire world.
Having a passion, sport and music are my, they make me happiest in the world.
I like music and sharing music with people.
What makes me really happy is like coming to school and seeing all my new friends' faces.
What makes me happiest is when I'm encouraged, when I'm doing something hard, when people stick by me. What makes me happy is how lucky we are that we have everything we have.